Hello and welcome to MXM Live. We have here with us Mr. Saurabh Verma, who's just set up his all-new agency, or I shouldn't be calling it an agency, but a platform-first MarTech firm called Wonderlab. Welcome to MXM Live, Saurabh.
My pleasure.
Always great speaking with you, but tell me, I know you are first an innovator and then an ad man. But what is platform first MarTech firm?
So, when you think about, what we do on a daily basis, Pradyuman, right? We every day use various platforms. Even right now, we are using Zoom as a platform, right? And when you look at value, that's where all the value really exists, right? Now, this really has two components. One is, what we call the service component. And the second is more a product component, right? From a service component, if people are going to be on these platforms, how do you really understand these platforms in a deep and meaningful way and create solutions on these platforms? Take the case of a typical digital creative agency, all organized around titles which have existed from the 1920s, right? Copywriters, art directors. When you talk about a digital agency, you will talk about a digital copywriter, a digital strategist, right? But from a platform first perspective, right, it's really about having a team Facebook or a team Jio, right? Or a team Instagram, right? People who deeply understand these platforms and create solutions on these platforms. Now, I'm not saying that the omni-channel is not important. The journey is very critical to understand. But once you have a omni-channel journey, right, you need deep experts to come on board and use these platforms to create specialist solutions on these platforms for clients to win. So that's the service component. From a product perspective, our take is that we don't want to just create a technology and platform for our clients. We have done that in the past. We want to actually create platforms which can help our clients win, right? And this can be about solving some meaningful problems, right, which exist in their lives from a brand or marketing perspective.
I know that in the past you have been among the first to use a lot of technology, but obviously you have set this up understanding that there is a need for it. So from your perspective, do you think there is an appetite for a platform-first offering like yours?
Yeah, we are betting on it.
you are, as I would say, a khatron ka khiladi. But the question is that you mentioned about omni-channel and you mentioned about the fact of the matter is that in this kind of a scenario, in the post-COVID scenario where there is an emphasis on reducing costs, so perhaps people prefer a platform agnostic kind of an offering where you use the same amount of creative heads and you then put it into various media baskets. There's the same kind of effort. So how does that fit in? And how does apart from the fact that you're betting on it, you would have obviously bet on it given a clear understanding of what the appetite is.
Yeah, you look at these platforms; they become so complex by themselves, right? If you don't know how to win on Instagram using Instagram stories, right? How will you succeed as a brand, right? So if you think that you will take the same piece of content you have created, let's say for an OTT platform, and you are going to replicate that across every single platform, it just wouldn't cut it. Think of a gaming platform that you and I might experience on a daily basis, which rewards us or incentivizes us every time we need to continue playing our game, right? And a brand needs to intervene during that 5 seconds. What does that experience look like, Pradyuman? Right? And if we feel genuinely as marketeers and as communication specialists that the same piece of content which we have created will apply here, it absolutely won't. And similarly, when you look at, migrating all the way to, let's say, an FMOT or a final transaction, right, your quality of content will completely change, right? So through your journey, through the context and through, the the behaviors that people have on different platforms, right, the experiences you create have to be meaningful, and that will actually drive greater ROI rather than lesser ROI. It doesn't cost a lot more, it costs a lot more to think about it, right? Actually, it's far more profitable to be platform first from a service perspective.
I appreciate. I clearly, each of the platforms require focused attention, but in terms of the kind of people you have, obviously it's yourself, it is Vandana, it is Rakesh, who all come from the marketing services ecosystem, the advertising ecosystem. So the obvious perception is that you are an advertising agency which is doing various things. So, you know, when it concerns technology, one would perhaps think of going to a technology first, or essentially a technology agency. So is there some kind of a conflict there, or how do you address it to prospective clients?
Yeah, there are two things to consider. One is what you have is only the initial reveal of a team, right? There is a much larger reveal which is in place, right? So wait for it, Pradyuman, number one, right? Number two, you know, we genuinely believe that even when you understand platforms, the quality of the storytelling is not going to go away, right? You still need to understand brands, right? Which most technology companies don't. You need to understand the context in which these brands operate, right? Which is not going to go away. And you need to understand storytelling and magic, right? Which is where the word wonder comes from. So all I would say is, you know, that to me are the two parts to the very interesting question that you asked.
So you said the reveal of other people, what's it going to be like? You are looking at, you know, I remember interviewing you in the past, and you mentioned about the need for technology folk in a creative agency. Like, is that something that you're looking at? Is that so are you going around shopping at some of the institutes of technology? Is that what you're looking at?
Duman, right, give it some time, in the fullness of time.
You know,
we have waited 9 months to get here, right? I'm sure you can wait for the next 8 weeks.
I was doing a day count, and it was 329 days. I must say 9 months, 329 days since you told me last that you were setting up something new, and we've been waiting and waiting and waiting. So tell me, how did you come about this thing? Because when I spoke to you last, which is when around 10th or 11th of December, 2019, you did speak about the fact that you are working on a new concept, and there were, of course, murmurs which exist in this entire ecosystem of ours. So what got you to doing something like this as against a regular kind of a creative agency?
First, I'm not a regular kind of guy, no, Pradyuman.
Absolutely, I agree.
So honestly, when you look at, you know, where the value is getting created from a marketeer's perspective, it is all moving in the direction of data and technology, right? Personalization at scale, right? Things which can be, which can be done in a far more effective manner than we do in the past, right? Also, when you look at technologies overall, right? We have never had so many technologies, whether it is, you know, IoT, AI, a whole bunch of technologies all maturing at the same time, right? It's never happened before. So we live in unprecedented times, right? And we spent the last 8-9 months not developing the service product, honestly, Pradyuman, but more the MarTech platforms, which is what we will reveal over the next 18 months. That is what has taken the time and the energy, right? So we've been, like I mentioned in my press release as well, our job is to curate, partner, and build some of these platforms bottom up, right? If we need to, right? Which can create value for clients. So that, you know, requires an extraordinary amount of effort to build, right? And that's what we've been doing.
And so I did see the communique that you had issued, where you mentioned that you will curate, partner, and build MarTech platforms that create meaningful experiences. And then, you know, there was a statement which was attributed to Vandana, which said you will see productized events, shopper marketing, retail, and brand activations. Now, some of that is, of course, we have to wait for activations to start happening. But what you mentioned an 18-month rollout, which is a very long period.
There are several platforms, and some of them, you know, are much more easier and ready, right? And you know, I mean, even if you look at the experiential landscape at the moment, and you look at some of the, you know, the heavy duty tech firms and how they are adapting to this landscape, right? They have literally created virtual events and technology platforms, right, to enable things, right? So there is a lot of work happening, you know, not just by us, but by many people, right, in this space, right, Pratyuman, right? And from our perspective, you will start seeing our offerings, right, over a period of time is what we are saying. So it's not true that from an experiential perspective, things have stopped. They have stopped physically, but from a virtual perspective, there is a lot that's going on. And, you know, a lot of the... I would say the more organized firms have already pivoted massively into digital virtual platforms, right? And clients are loving it.
I appreciate, but you know, we've not really had, and which is where, you know, I'm asking you questions about stuff, but I do know that you would have thought through the entire thing, but there's no other agency which is perhaps talking about technology that the way you are, perhaps you know, a couple of them are offering technology solutions, but not too many of them.
Yeah, you know, we are not offering a service. See, what happens also what we did in the past, Pradyuman, right, to be fair, was we built technology for and on behalf of our clients, right? We did not build platforms for ourselves which multiple clients could use over a period of time. We never created marketplaces, right? And what we are trying to do, or our ambition is to create several of these platforms, right? At the same time, right? So that we can help, you know, liberate ourselves from what I call the tyranny of the service business.
Tyranny of the service business. That's interesting that you say that. And that's also a kind of a comment on the way things are. 9 months hence, how do you look back at you know, what is your view of the way the business has been doing across? Because I'm sure you see stuff that's happening.
So I think, you know, when you look at the value that, you know, we add as a community, it is extraordinary, right? I mean, I can share with you data points. Right, 20% of all intangible value, right, across all companies is intangible value, which is called brand, right? So from a value perspective, it's extraordinary. And yet, when you look at the pressure that exists on us as a community, that has also been unprecedented. So I think, you know, somewhere along the line, we need to challenge ourselves to do something completely different, right, in the way we both work and in the way we charge, right, on both those elements. And that's what we are essentially trying to do, right, at the moment, or at least attempting to do, right, Pradyuman, right, to be fair, where challenge ourselves both in the way we work and in the way we charge, right? From a perspective of the way we work, we have said that, you know, we have to not just be in the service business, but we have to create platforms which are meaningful from a client's perspective, which helps them have an unfair advantage in the marketplace. From a perspective of the service business, we are saying that, listen, we have to be platform first in the way we position ourselves, in the way we organize ourselves, and in the way we create value for our clients, right? Because clients want to today win on a Jio as a platform. They want to win on YouTube as a platform. And every time there is a new platform that comes up, right, there are various ways of creating stories on those platforms. How do you tell the story in the most meaningful way is where the whole game will get to play. So there is a service part of the business, and then there is a product part of the business. I actually think the product part of the business is actually over a period of time, is actually the most exciting from a client's perspective in terms of the value that we can create and add for them, right? And the last part is really how do you really, charge for what you create, right? Which is truly valuable. And our sense is that will only happen through income, which is one, annuity income, right? Which means that as you scale and as technology scales, right, you you can see a clear path to an incredible, revenue model. And second, by actually putting your skin in the game from a service perspective, right? So we have a couple of new models which have, never been tried before, at least from an Indian context, right? Where we are actually, putting a real skin in the game, right? For the clients whose ambitions we really believe in.
Which means that you will perhaps look at charging a client less, but perhaps taking a stake in the business or in the sales. Is that what you're saying?
There are a couple of models, right? Best that we keep it off this conversation at the moment, right? That's where a lot of the advantage for us really comes in. There is a certain methodology in the way we charge for it, right? We don't really offer it to every client. It's for clients whose ambition we really believe in and where we believe we have an opportunity to make a significant difference in their storytelling.
So what's been the response? Obviously, I remember messaging you a month back when I did hear from some clients about the fact that you are setting this up and you are all set to unveil this. And of course, it took a few weeks to hear of it. But what has been the response of clients? You have some fantastic relationships already. What is the feedback and what is the response? Are they buying into what you're saying? And have you hooked some clients already? Now, don't say you'll have to wait for it.
You have to wait for it. Now, Pradyuman, honestly, the truth is we have taken this much amount of time because we wanted to create something which is meaningful for our clients, right? Ultimately, there's a lot of back-end work which has happened, right, to make sure that whatever we create is the right thing, right, ultimately, and can create success for us. We did not rush into building this or launching this. Right, we could have done that in December, on December 13th or 10th, right, when we spoke, right, 11th, right. We could have on that day had a formal launch, taken a logo and, said we are ready to go, right. So it's taken us 10 months because there is a lot of back-end work which has happened in terms of putting what we are doing together, right. I think right now the excitement levels are unprecedented, right. But that is anyway supposed to happen when we do something after this period of time. Now the real test starts. So, right? And, the team and I have to get together and deliver on the ambitions of our clients.
So you already got some clients and you're not announcing it now, you'll announce at the right time. Is that what you're saying? Or is that what I should read?
Yeah, I think beyond, the clients that we've got, which anyway you'll come to know in the next, 4 weeks, right, to Pradyuman, right? I think, we are still on a... we have a massive ambition and we are on a base camp, right? So we have a Everest to climb and a long way to go before we are satisfied. So this is just the start of a journey. Of course, everybody's excited by it. But if you ask me, we're on ground zero, right?
And what kind of industries would you be working with? Are you looking at across industries? Is there some kind of an industry that you have a special affinity for? For instance, I know you've done some great work with automobiles in the past. You had some great ideas in terms of the Bajaj V. You did some great work with retail clients, etc. So is there some kind of a special affinity that you have that Wonder Labs will have towards?
Yeah, obviously we all have our own passions and, some of the products we are creating are in that direction. So one of the things, we are fascinated by is the whole B2B2C industry, right? That's a huge passion for us. When you look at one of the big learnings is that, how do you really digitize a distributor and an agent in today's day and age, right? So when you look at, let's say, a client like Life Insurance Corporation, or LIC, right? They have 12 lakh agents. What do you do with them, right? How do you create a product which is meaningful from their perspective? So, you know, that's, you know, for example, a huge passion project for us at the moment, right? Similarly, you know, when you look at several spaces, right, depending on what we are trying to do from a build perspective, of course, BFSI is very exciting, right, as an industry, right? And overall, right, when you think of it from a Wonder Lab perspective, you know, we love, you know, young startups, right? I mean, the ambition and the energy they have is just so unprecedented. And that in many ways us, right, as a team, right? So we love the ambitious, you know, young entrepreneur, right? We are young entrepreneurs in our journey, right? You know, we love partnering with some of these, you know, young ambitious entrepreneurs in their journey. And we hope to make some magic with a few of them happen.
Except that since you're talking about startups, they don't give you too much money. So you will, you know, perhaps in their success, you will, only if they're successful, will you grow with them?
Yeah, obviously, you know, that's really the thinking, right? But, you know, the future of India is not in the past, it's actually in these startups, right? It's in the ambitions of, you know, and in the dreams of these of this young India, right? And we are fascinated by, you know, how technology, right, you know, is actually going to be used, right, to disrupt every single marketplace. And there are so many examples of these, right, at the moment, right, even as we've been through a very tough phase, right, as a world economy because of COVID, right? People who have disrupted their industries because of technology, right? And we are just fascinated by some of these startups and, you know, what they've managed to do during this time.
You know, I wasn't planning to look at discussing the past, but how, you know, your communique mentions the fact that all of you were in the Publicis group. So are there anybody else from the Publicis group who are looking at joining you?
Yeah, you know, it's always Pradyuman, a bunch of people who enjoy working with each other, who come together to make magic happen, right? It's as simple as that, Pradyuman. You know, I mean, how that's maybe the best way for me to answer it. You know, when you look at it from a perspective of creating magic, right, or any organization, you know, usually all organizations go through three phases. The first is what we call storming, right? Then some kind of norming, normalization, and then performing, right? In our case, right, that doesn't exist because many of us have worked with each other for the last 6-7 years, and we have each other's back, right? And that's what really matters when you are a young entrepreneur, you know, who's starting off, right, to try and create value in today's day and age.
So are there any more people joining you from the past whom we perhaps know?
Pradyuman, it will in the fullness of time. Everything will be revealed in the fullness of time.
And this is all self-funded, or do you have some investments from anyone over here?
We do. I can't speak about it, but obviously we are well funded.
And you are looking at an 18-month horizon. So is there something that, you know, you could our entire discussion has been on slightly esoteric stuff or intangibles that you've discussed, but is there something that, you know, if you were to make, say, an elevator pitch, or you just meet somebody on the, you know, these days you don't meet too many people in the elevator, but if you suddenly encounter someone and you want to talk about your agency, how will you say, are you different from the agency that you work with, perhaps?
Yeah, so two parts, and I think I've already repeated that, and I'll repeat it all over again, right? The first one is, you know, we are platform first from a service perspective, which means all our teams are really focused on delivering value on these platforms, number one. And second, we have a bunch of incredible MarTech platforms, which we own, which can help our clients get an unfair advantage. That's the elevator pitch, Pradyuman.
That's interesting. You know, I'm going to have to speak to you once again soon, and perhaps more often than once, because I know you're going to be revealing things in the months to come. But all the very best. It was Always a pleasure speaking with you, and thank you very much, and best wishes to you and the team.
Thank you so much, Pradyuman. We need all the wishes and all the good luck, right? Really appreciate this conversation, right? And yes, the next, I would say, 6 months will be very exciting, right? And you will see a lot more in the next 4 weeks, which will actually set the agenda for the next 6 months.
Right? Thank you very much, right?
My pleasure, Pradyuman.